I'm Shamina. I'm a researcher and lecturer in the University of Florence, Italy. Basically, I'm a kind of soil microbial ecologist. I'm studying this part and how the changes in microbial community can have an impact on nutrient cycles. So legume-cereal intercropping for sustainable agriculture across the Europe. From title you can understand that what we are trying to do is legume-based intercropping across the Europe, because this is not like a common kind of agriculture system in the Europe, because in Europe normally they more focused on monoculture and the kind of intensive agriculture system. What we are doing, we are trying to do is to increase the willingness of the European farmer to adopt this strategy. What we actually trying to looking at how the different combination of legume and cereals in under a different pedoclimatic condition across the Europe can improve the soil fertility. So this is one of our main aim, and also to improve the knowledge to the European farmer about this system and their willingness to adopt this system in their farming. It has many benefits, like for example, the legume can fix the nitrogen, so it can reduce your fertilization input. But intercropping can also have more benefits, like it can reduce the pesticides and it can increase the soil fertility. Because I'm a soil microbial ecologist, so for me the more interesting thing and the outcomes I'm looking is that how the different combination of intercroppings under a different pedoclimatic condition can impact the soil microbial community and their function, and how these changes in a microbial community and their functions can have an impact on the plant production. The other, if you look at the environmental perspective, at what level we can reduce the fertilization rate, like synthetic fertilizer especially, and also is there possibility that with intercropping we can reduce the amount of pesticides and again the greenhouse gas emission. So we establishing like 20 on-farm trials in seven European countries, which is Italy, Germany, Czech Republic, Poland, UK, and Denmark. So here the farmers are main actor. So we are creating a kind of two-way communication channel, so it can also help us and making the new policies according to their knowledge and their system. So the involvement of 180 farmers is a big thing. Establishing 20 living labs in one country is a not the easy task. If you read the project, it's very easy or the simple project. But if you go in deeper and deeper, it has many layers. Even in the research, we have multi-dimensional thinking. Like we have soil scientists, some are microbial ecologists, some are agronomists, some are botanists, and some are just working with the machine learning, the modeler, and some social science. It's a very diverse and multi-dimensional project. So if keeping everything in one line and putting all things together is a big challenge. So these are the challenge we have. But I think we are doing very well because all the partners are very active. We find a solution to fix the things. So I think we will doing good. And end of project, we will have a kind of very interesting output and the results. I'm coordinating this project, so I'm very excited, but also nervous because it's a big thing, yeah, because I have a huge responsibility taking care of all the partners and responsible to answer to the European Union. And other two things is that about our living lab, because if you look the previous European project, I think none of the projects have like 180 or like field trials or the case study, yeah? So I'm very excited about this. I'm a vegetarian because I'm coming from India, and in India, especially from the one region, the Gujarat, where 90% of people are vegetarian. And we, like if you look, we have like 100 kind of recipe from legumes, and I eat like different legumes like 3 or 4 times in a week, yeah? So I love legumes.